Okay, let's start. So, hello everybody. I'm Lydia Bruno. I work for Agri Sud-Ouest Innovation, which is the coordinator of the DIVA project. I thank you for your participation in this first workshop of the afternoon, organized as part of the DIVA final event. So, in DIVA, the SMEs has the opportunity to get funding, to get European funding. So we thought it could be this event could be a good opportunity to present you some other opportunities in the sector of research and innovation. So I am glad to welcome today with me Cristina Gouveia. She works for the National Agency of Innovation in Portugal, and she is also the national contact point for the program Horizon Europe. And she will also present you some opportunities to get funding at EU level. And just also to tell you before we start that the chat is open. So if you wish to ask a question, you can do it. Don't hesitate to add comment or add question, and we will answer it at the end of this presentation. So Cristina, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Lydia, for the introduction and also for having invited me to present the opportunities that may exist in Horizon Europe, which is the new program at the European level that funds innovation and research. And so it's always good to spread the words. I understand that most of the audience is part of an SME, although it may have different profiles of people. But so I tried to frame my presentation focused on SMEs, and also considering that they don't have a previous experience in, or at least they haven't had much experience in the previous framework programs. So they will, my presentation intends to give a roadmap to try to find possibilities for funding, considering research and innovation activities. So I hope now you see my screen. So I understand that most of the audience are from either from the digital side of technologies or from the agricultural part. So I'm also trying to find an emphasis on my presentation on these two topics. So the idea is that innovation is always a risk activity, and so that there is a need for getting and having access to some funding to support the sharing of the risk, because the idea is that innovation also creates a lot of creates or develops the economy of Europe, and so it will be something that we need to promote and support. So we will be a region that promotes a very good quality of life for their citizens, but also he has the leadership in technology and in economic development. So there are a lot of funds at the European level that support research and innovation activities. The problem, especially for the newcomers, is to understand what is the best fund and the best opportunity to match your own needs. And so I would say that although Horizon Europe is the biggest fund to support research and innovation, because it's only focused on that, there are other funds that you should also look at, especially the digital program, but also the Connecting Europe facility, which also has some opportunities and other thematic project funds like the SPACE or the EU for Health Fund. The biggest one is Horizon Europe, but you have also other funds that are not focused on research and innovation, but they also fund projects dedicated to research and innovation. And I would also would like to signpost these funds like these programs like LIFE or the Erasmus Plus. The funds that are inside of the broader European policies, like the Common Agricultural Policy or the European Maritime and Fisheries Fund, or even the structural funds that always have, all these funds have some components dedicated to innovation and research. So are always good points to look for support. But this presentation is focused on Horizon Europe, which involves our almost 100 billion euros. A small part of that amount comes from the resilience and recovery plan. So it has some particular conditions to have access to, like it's focused on some areas of Horizon Europe, particularly the digital, the green component of the where the agriculture projects are also considered, and also on the innovation component of Horizon Europe. So, and they need to be spent in the next years. So they will have some specificities in terms of conditions to have access to that pocket of money. The idea behind of all these funds, and particularly Horizon Europe, is to focus on the impact that research and innovation activities may have, because the idea is that it will be the driving force to maintain Europe in the leadership of the research area, but also in terms of economic development. In terms of economic development, I guess we are not in the leadership anymore, but we want to be a relevant and significant region in the world. The policies that are the main areas that will be supported by these funds are related mainly to the green transition, the idea of the digital transformation and to make Europe fit for the digital age. Also to consider to give good conditions to attract the most talented researchers and innovators, to have a strong Europe in the world, and at the same time it respects and makes European democracy stronger, and also to promote our European way of life. As I said before, the problem here is to find exactly where the money is, and I'm going to try to give you some insights. First of all, most of the programs are organized considering the stage of development of your research and innovation work. So if you don't know this scale, the technology readiness level, I would say it's something that you need to look at, because when you go to this type of events, when people are talking about funding, they will not take the time to explain you what this scale is, and will talk about only like TRL 1, 2, 3 or TRL 9. It was a scale developed at the time of the moon launching project at NASA. And it gives you an idea and a way to compare the stage of development of your technology. And the TRL1 means that your idea is in a very idea stage. You only have a rough concept and you're still need to do all the research to understand if the theory is if your idea is a valid one, and if it will work, and if it's if it will be like you imagine. So if you go further on the TRL level scale, you're targeting to get more into the market. So TRL 9, it means that you are ready to be launched, or to launch your product in the market. In between, like in the stage of 4 to 6, you have already developed some proof of concepts, but you still need to do some research, but you know already how to go further to get into the market. So that's something you need to be comfortable with, knowing this scale. So to understand what will be the program or the opportunity that fits your needs. Because most of the programs will tell you this is a call that wants projects at this TRL level, either the initial ones or the middle ones, or the ones more close to the market. And that makes quite a difference in terms of the possibilities that you will have to apply for a specific opportunity. The other important thing is that most of the funding opportunities require that you work in a consortium, and that consortium needs to have at least 3 entities from 3 different European countries. European countries from the European Union, the 27, or countries that do not belong to the European Union but have signed an agreement of cooperation, which in the jargon they are called as associated countries. The UK is one example of the future associated country to Horizon Europe, but countries like Switzerland, Norway, or even Iceland, or Israel, are countries that in the past have signed cooperation agreements to be able to participate in Horizon 2020, and they are expected also to be part of Horizon Europe. In that case, you need to have at least 3 different countries, and one of the new rules for the Horizon Europe is that in the 3 countries, you need to have at least one that is a member state of the European Union. So sometimes this can be a problem, particularly for SMEs, to find the right consortium and the right partners to create a strong and good proposal. And that's something you need to be, to do some work to be strong in having always good partners when you're trying to do a proposal. But acknowledging that for SMEs, sometimes it's also difficult to find the right consortiums, and particularly when they want to develop a product that will change the market. There are some programs, some specific opportunities that target only SMEs, and they can go on a mono beneficiary type of application. So they can go on their own. But they are signposted in the program of Horizon Europe. Most of them are under the umbrella of a new organization inside of the Horizon Europe that is called the European Innovation Council.
But they are the exception, not the rule. The rule is usually a consortium type of projects. What are the conditions to that you will have the opportunity to receive funding and other types of support? Mainly, there are three types of calls that they differ in terms of the TRL level that they target, and also they differ in terms of the amount of funding they give per project. So most of the early stage projects, which are called the research and innovation actions, they are funded at 100% plus 25% of indirect costs. While if you're already have some research work done and you want to consolidate and validate and demonstrate your ideas and technologies, you will be more suitable to apply for opportunities that are called innovation actions, and they have smaller funds. They funded 70% of the project cost. The other type that is also mentioned as one of the main types of opportunities that exist in Horizon Europe are the coordination and support actions that are mainly to support the development of new policies and new communities. So they are not, they're usually they target more government and associations of sectors and users than, although SMEs and companies can also participate, but they are more to promote the coordination of the policies and the results of research that has been achieved. The other thing that is also important for you to know is that all proposals will be evaluated according three criteria. Excellence, which means it's the quality of the work that you have developed, or you intend to develop, of course, and the impact, which means how the result of your project will affect the European society, both in terms of the quality of life of the European citizens, and also in terms of promoting the competitiveness of the European countries. And the third is the quality and the efficiency of the implementation. Mainly, this criteria is to assess if you have the right team to promote the work you're saying you are going to do, and if you have a good work plan and a good notion of how to achieve the results you're aiming to achieve. So these are the three criteria. It doesn't matter actually what type of call you're going to apply. What it differs from call to call is the weight of which criteria. There are calls that give more weight to the excellence type of criteria, while others have more weight in the impact criteria. So the other variable that is important for you to navigate in terms of finding the best opportunities for you is to understand if you want to apply for funding for a specific activity that you already know what you want to do, and in that case you don't want to follow the strategies defined by the Commission. And if that's the case, you're looking for open type of calls, or what we usually call as a bottom-up approach, where there's no indication from the part of the Commission in terms of what they are looking for to fund. They only give the idea of the type of instrument that exists, and then don't tell you exactly what they are looking for to achieve as research results. The other type of opportunities, and most of the opportunities, I would say, are organized in a different way. They are they follow a top-down approach, which means that the type of research that will be funded by the European Commission will follow the rules published in working programs. They will be published every 2 years. The last one will have a 3-year scope, but these working programs tell you exactly what they is the Commission expecting to achieve in terms of the topics that they considered strategic for Europe to be subject of research and innovation activities, the conditions in terms of they want in that topic to promote international collaboration, or if they want to promote specific policy goals. And so in that case, you need to follow exactly what they tell you that they are aiming to fund to have a successful proposal. So when you're trying to understand what are the calls that may fit your interests, you always need to understand if it's one type of call that already tells you exactly what it's going to be researched, and then you need to follow what is written in the work program, or if it's an open call, a bottom-up call that don't give you detailed information in terms of areas of research, but give you only the main eligibility and assessment criteria, so you may apply with any idea that you may have. So in case if you're trying to apply to a top-down approach, the easiest way to beat the others is always to read the work program, because it's where exactly all the rules are defined. But and for you to find the work programs of Horizon Europe, you need to go to the funding and tenders portal of the European Commission, and all the work programs are published. At this time, they are not yet published because only the general framework of Horizon Europe was launched and public available, but the programs for the specific areas of research of the Horizon Europe will be only published in the next 2 months. Some will start earlier than others. Some will start in March, others will start in April. That's something that is going on and being decided right now. So the other important thing for you to do, besides reading the working programs of the opportunities that you may find and consider interesting for you, is to register at the Funding and Tenders portal. That's where all the opportunities are published. There, that's also where you need to have your identification number. And you can also use that portal to see results of the previous funding programs, and also it's through that portal that you will submit your application, your proposal. The other thing, it's also important for you to acknowledge in your research, is that the idea of the European Commission, which was approved by all the organs of governing the European Commission, including the member states, implies that the research that will be funded needs to have European impact and European wide value. So I'm now going to enter in more details in terms of what are the type of opportunities that will exist in Horizon Europe? As I mentioned, since it's a so big fund, the idea to make it easier to access and to find the right opportunity is to give you a structure that you may understand and try to follow it, because it will this structure will condition all the information organizations. So if you go to the funding and tenders portal, if you want to find the working programs, the working programs for 2021 and 2022 will be organized and divided in folders according to this structure that you can see in at your screen. And this is a structure that is very similar to the structure that existed in Horizon 2020. And basically it divides the opportunities in three main pillars. Again, these pillars are also targeting different levels of TRLs. Like pillar one, it's for basic research, and there you may find instruments that support individual researchers to do their own idea in terms of, to follow their own idea in terms of research areas. And these are mainly the European Research Council grants. You may probably have heard about them, because the European Commission wants these to be like the Nobel or the Oscar type of grants of the European research. Then there's the Marie Slodowska-Curie, I'm trying to say it right, that also support educational and research targeting special universities, although it may be, they are open to every type of entity, but they are basically the Marie Curie grants that are known in among the researchers as a way to get access to resources and educational programs across Europe. And then you have also the research infrastructures, which is very important, mainly for scientific activities. And so and it's the instrument that the Commission have to make the research done in Europe to have it's the instrument that the Commission has to have the possibility for researchers to have access to impactful infrastructures. So because there are infrastructures that are very expensive and very specialized, and this is a way to give access to all European countries to that type of research and to that type of infrastructures, and create infrastructures that are meaningful and impactful across Europe. Then you have pillar two, which is the where you can find the calls that target specific themes and areas that intend mainly to increase and solve some societal challenges. Now the wording, it doesn't put too much emphasis on the societal challenges, but more on the technologies that are used to solve and resolve some problems in terms of development. And so you have clusters, six clusters. Each one is focused on a theme. The first one is health, the second cultural creativity and inclusive society, the third civil security, the fourth digital, which I think it's an important one for you, industry and space. The fifth is the climate, energy and mobility, and the sixth is food, economy, natural resources, agriculture and environment. And that cluster is the one I follow as a national contact point in Portugal. And so it will be the one that I feel more comfortable talking to you. The third pillar, in this second pillar, the opportunities are mainly top-down, which means that most of the research that is funded through Pillar 2 are very detailed written in the work programs, which is not what happens in Pillar 1 and Pillar 3. Pillar 3 is it's focused on activities that intend to target or have the potential to target and the market and create and the possibility to create new products and new services and bring them to the market. And so that's where you may find opportunities for single beneficiaries, such as SMEs, the European Innovation Council, which is the biggest part of the budget of Pillar 3, focus most of it in SMEs. And then you have the European Innovation Ecosystems, which intends to make the innovation ecosystem, like accelerators, incubators, NCPs, the national contact points, and that type of support services stronger across Europe. And you have the European Institute of Innovation and Technology that supports activities that connect universities in terms of their educational programs, researchers in terms of the research they develop, and companies. So it's also a good place to look for opportunities if you're an SME, because they have a lot of acceleration activities. Some of them are funded, so they are good opportunities to find for and look for seed money. Then you have an horizontal part of this structure that is where you find the widening program, which has funding opportunities for both research and also more close to market activities. But the goals of this program is to compensate countries that have compensate is not the right word, but it's to support and help countries that have weaker research and innovation ecosystems, that are have lower levels of research and innovation indicators, to solve that problems, the problems they have, and become stronger. So Europe as a whole has a much stronger position in terms of research and innovation. Let me tell you, they are not restricted to the widening countries, which means the countries with the lower performance indicators in terms of research and innovation. They are also open to any country and associated country that may wish to participate in the programs and create strong networks among different types of countries and the different types of innovation ecosystems. And the other part that is also on the horizontal part of this program is to talk about how this European and this European research and innovation landscape can be organized and can be more understandable to the common citizen. It's called the European Research Area. So I gave you a very detailed explanation of the structure. So if you want to find a specific opportunity, that the idea of the three pillars, it's good for you to start organizing your searches and your information, or to find information specific on the areas that are you interested. But there are also two new concepts in Horizon Europe that it's good for you to be aware, because they are new ways of thinking about the funding that is available for researchers and innovators across Europe. And these are these two new concepts, the missions and the European partnerships. The European partnerships, it's not exactly a new concept. It's more a new approach to an old concept. So the European partnerships, it's an idea to allow different actors, mainly the European Commission and public or private actors, to make partnerships so they can access to additional sources of funds or resources. And so in terms of the areas of agriculture, there's one partnership that has been very active and very successful in the past, which is the bio economy industries partnership that had partnerships among the European Commission and companies and entities that wanted to be part of that partnership and would be interested to give financial contributions to be part of that group and promote activities together, both research and innovation projects, but also networking and community creation activities. And in Horizon Europe, the idea is that the rules for partnerships are simpler and more easily understandable. So they are less fragmented, although there are, I think, 49 different partnerships already planned. And so the idea is to make them more simple, but it's still a complex landscape to navigate. But I guess the main idea for you as SMEs that you need to take with you is that if you want to apply for an opportunity that is created by a partnership, they will be published in the tender portal. So if you go to the tender portal, you may find all the opportunities that exist that are funded by Horizon Europe, and you cannot be surprised if they are different or specific rules than the ones you are expected if they are funded by through the umbrella of a partnership. But it's more a technocrat type of difference than exactly an important concept for you to understand or to have to understand everything that exists in terms of partnerships, because it's quite diverse and complex to understand everything. And so that's the European partnerships, but then missions, it's a new concept and it's the one that I'm more fond of, because it's the idea of creating and funding projects under the umbrella of missions. It's a new idea of supporting research and development activities that was proposed by a professor from the UK. Actually, she's Italian, but she works in the UK, Mariana Mazzucato, that has made a lot of research work and came up with the idea that the better way to fund research is a type of model that uses the Moon project that was developed in the 60s and it intends to mobilize all the resources in terms of goals for the society. So in terms of how they will be working in the Horizon Europe, is that in the beginning, in the beginning of the Horizon Europe, there are already five missions that were identified as very important goals for the European society, and they are from different areas, such as like health, that is focused on cancer, and others more interesting for you probably, like the climate resilient Europe, or the ones that is concerned about soil, or the climate neutral cities, and or the oceans are the five missions have very defined and clear targets in terms of what they want to achieve, and they intend to be the implementation plan that will be followed by each of these missions will be defined with the involvement of the society, with the involvement of the public, and also they will use funds not only from the Horizon Europe, but from other sectoral funds. For instance, when we're talking about climate resilient Europe, we are also talking that the DG Climate and DG Research in the Union, European Union, need to have a common plan to use and fund research to achieve the policy goals in terms of climate. So this is a new way of funding research because it requires the integration of different sectors, and also it requires a lot of involvement of the public. And so it's still uncertain how it will work. In these new next years, there will be 5 million euros for the missions, for each of them. So I think there will be possibilities to have access to funds, but most of it to have to participate in a policy instrument that intends to solve the most serious problems that we have as a region. So, because you're focused on the digital sector and the agricultural sector, I just want to go through the topics, not the topics, but the areas that are planned to happen in the two main areas of Horizon Europe. Cluster 4, which is called Digital Industry and Space, and Cluster 6, which targets the food, the agriculture, the environment, the bioeconomy, and natural resources type of projects. So what is important for you to know specific for these two type of clusters is that the opportunities, as I told you, are described in detail. They are mostly top down in the working programs. They are composed by hundreds of pages. They have divided these big areas according to different destinations, and under each destination, you will have the specific call for you to apply propose a new idea or a new concept. Following the rules the Commission published in the working program. So for the cluster four, you have six destinations. One is more, all of them are connected to the digital component, but destination one is the climate neutral, circular and digitized production. Destination two is related to increase the autonomy of key strategic value chains for a resilient industry. Destination three is about world-leading data and computing technologies. The four is about digital and emerging technologies for competitiveness and fit for the Green Deal. The Destination 5 is open strategic autonomy in developing, deploying, and using global space-based infrastructure, services, applications, and data. So it's very targeting on the space component of this cluster. And Destination 6 is focused on the human-centered and ethical development of digital industrial technologies. So these are like the big ideas. And so if you, it's a way to for you to screen where can you find the opportunity that interests you the most. And then under each destination, there will be topics that will be mainly the topic of the specific call. Cluster four has deadlines in July and August. They are not yet public and known, but I'm just giving you this information because if you want to, or if you think that there may be opportunities for you in this cluster, you need to contact your national contact point and to try to find together with them where are the best and the most suitable opportunities for you. In cluster six, which is the food, bioeconomy, natural resources, agriculture, and the environment, is the one that I follow. So it's I'm also more aware of the opportunities that exist there. So if you have any doubt specific about cluster six, you may ask me. But it's informed by all these policies that most of you may have heard about it, like the European Green Deal, the Common Agriculture Policy, and others. And they give you the map in terms of policy goals that the Commission aims to achieve in terms to decide why it will fund this opportunity, this type of research and other, and not the other. Cluster six has seven destinations. They are again like the big themes where you can find specific opportunities. You will have biodiversity and ecosystem services, fair, healthy, and environmentally friendly food systems from primary production to consumption, circular economy and bioeconomy sectors, clean environment and air pollution, land, oceans, and water for climate action, resilient, inclusive, healthy, and green rural, coastal, and urban communities, and innovative governance, environmental observations, and digital solutions in support of the Green Deal. So these are like the big themes, and under them there will be specific opportunities. The deadlines, there will be some opportunities that will have only one phase in terms of evaluation, and they will be open in April. And the deadline is in the 1st of September of 2021. And there will be other calls that will follow that will only open in October. And the final deadline will be in February of next year already. So that's a not yet official calendar, but I don't think it will be very different from these dates. Finally, and at last, there are pillar three, that the opportunities that exist in pillar three that target mainly SMEs. It will be the European Innovation Council will be launched in 18 and 19th of March. So if you're interested to find more about these opportunities, yeah, that's a good event to participate in. And the idea of the European Innovation Council is to support and promote the development of companies that have the potential to be a unicorn, which means to be a company with a really, really high valuation. Of course, to become a unicorn, which is a creature that doesn't exist, it has a lot of risks. So what the Commission wants to fund is companies that have a very good idea and a very good new technology, that they have an idea and the technology that is disruptive of the market, and it's based on a continuous demand of developing technologies, and that has the potential to become the world leader in that market. And they may invest up to 17.5 million of euros in a single company. So it's a very interesting and attractive program. The European Innovation Council also funds and supports ideas that are in a very, very early stage, but may have the potential, again, very high risk, and because they also have a really big ambition to become the technologies of the future. And so the idea to make these type of ideas under the same umbrella than the companies that are already working to get into the market is to have the opportunity to monitor early development ideas and try to identify results that have the potential to create new unicorns in the future and support them since the beginning. And so the instrument that supports that type of ideas is called Pathfinder, while the instrument that supports SMEs that already have an idea demonstrated and they want to scale up, it's called Accelerator. And then the European Innovation Council also has some opportunities to make projects that have the good results in the past, projects that were funded by the European Commission, both by the European Research Council or by a previous program that existed in Horizon 2020 that is called Future and Emerging Technologies, to evolve a little bit further and be able to apply in the end of the project directly to the accelerator, and that are called Pathfinder Transition Activities. I'm just going to end and tell you that I know I gave a long talk with a lot of details, and probably you have forgotten most of them at this point, but you should know that to apply and be successful to have access to the opportunities in Horizon Europe is possible, and you are not alone in that journey that requires some resilience, because it's not easy to win and to get to everything and achieve every goal you may set to yourselves, but you'll not be alone, and you have at least two strong networks that you may access and get in contact to, that in every country of Europe, and I would strongly advise you to explore that two local resources. One of them is the Enterprise Europe Network that has people across Europe and even farther away than Europe. It involves other countries in the world that gives support to companies to find where the best opportunity in terms of funding exists, and they also follow, they don't follow only the Horizon Europe, but they follow other European funding programs. And so you may contact them. You may also contact your national delegates to Horizon Europe or your national contact points, and the ones I'm giving it, showing here to you are the Portuguese ones, including the minister. And I'm part of that. I'm one of the pictures that was in the previous slide, but I'm focused on the Horizon Europe Cluster 6 and also on our European Innovation Council. So if you want to contact any, if you want to contact me or any of my other colleagues, please feel free to do it. And I want to tell you just a little, very shortly, what type of support you will have. Both the Enterprise Europe Network and your national contact points organize events to disseminate the opportunities, and also they facilitate matchmaking for you to create and increase your network of potential partners to apply for a project. The info days that the Commission promote also include that opportunity, and they are very important resources. We help companies and entities to review and discuss and give you any information that will be able to clear some doubts in terms of how to write a proposal and how to follow the rules. We do some training, both in doing the filling the template for the proposals or creating a pitch to promote your idea and business. And we also do for the instruments that have interviews as one of the evaluation steps. We do some interview mock-ups nationally, so we will prepare each company to be better prepared. And the thing is, we need to work in teams. So contact your local contact points, your local Enterprise Europe network. I'm sure you will be welcomed and well received. And if you need something from us, particularly from me, please be free to contact us, contact me. So I think I'm done, Olivia. I hope I haven't killed anyone by boredom, but yeah.
We have 3 minutes before the Zoom will the session will close. So thank you very much, Christina. Just one question: is it possible for a startup to participate in an EU project? So a newly created enterprise.
Yes.
Okay.
Startups, and even if they have not yet been constituted as a startup in the European Innovation Council, a single person can apply at the first stage to have an evaluation of their idea. And then if they go have the green light, they can constitute the company afterwards.
Okay. Perfect, thank you. Last question. So you confirm the code will be published in April?
Sorry?
The call for Eurozone Europe will be published in April, March?
Yes, for Cluster 6, yes. For the European Innovation in March.
Okay, perfect. Just before we finish, I just share some information. So there are going to be two more workshops this afternoon during this event. The next one, it will be at 3 o'clock. It's about operational facilities, the necessary step to demonstrate digital innovations. And the last one will be about feedbacks and recommendations to the European Commission. So it's a workshop with other InnoSup project. So thank you, Christina, for your presentation. And thank you all for your participation. So I hope you learn a lot of things, and I hope to see you in another workshop. Bye.
Bye.